All right, Michael, so I'm going to deal with your request by trying to go through an exercise with you where we try to figure out what these options are. And there's going to be a secret point here that has to do, as always, with abstraction. So here's what I'm going to do. So we've got the same little grid world that we had before up here, but I have introduced another grid world. Do you recognize this grid world?
It looks like a very tiny little game of Pac-Man.
It is exactly a tiny little game of Pac-Man. So what I want to do with this tiny little game of Pac-Man, which, again, is just a grid world, is I want to explore this notion of options and see what we can figure out about them. So everybody remembers Pac-Man? So, Michael, for the benefit of the audience that has never played Pac-Man, all zero of them, why don't you explain to us how Pac-Man works?
Sure. So in the game, we're a little Jewish guy named Pac-Man, and we're running around in the grid. We're the yellow guy, and we chomp, 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 chomp. We can't go through the blue walls. We're being pursued by, it looks like sort of.
Careful.
Yeah. I'm going to go with French fry goblins from McDonald's. So as we move around in the grid, we consume those little dots, the little pellets, and that gives us points. If we can actually clear all the little dots and the big dots from the screen, then we have successfully completed the screen and we get an even more exciting challenge next.
Yes.
But I want to say that there's one other important thing is that if we eat one of those power pellets, the big fat dots, then the tables are turned on our ghost friends, and we can actually, if we touch them, consume them. We get points, and then they have to, I believe their eyeballs run away and regenerate.
Yes, that's exactly what happens, just like in real life. So, yeah, so if the ghosts touch us, we die unless we've had the power pellets, and then they allow us to eat the ghost, but only for a limited amount of time, right? It doesn't last forever.
Oh, good point.
Once I hit a big fat pellet, I don't get to do it for the rest of the game. It lasts for some amount of time.
For a limited time only.
Limited time only. And I don't remember if that time is fixed or if that time is random. I think it's fixed, but maybe not. And, you know, there are different versions of Pac-Man that have slightly different rules, but those are the basic rules. So here's the exercise I want to go through. Now, obviously, and when I say obvious, I'm saying that to beat down anyone who doesn't think it's obvious. There are four atomic actions, left, right, up, and down, north, south, east, and west, just like in any other grid world. And that's pretty much what we're given. So here's the exercise I want you to go through. It's got sort of two parts to it. And this is actually an exercise that we have done with other people as a part of studies we've done. I want you to think about options that you might create here. Like if you were going to describe to a human being, here are the things you need to accomplish. Here are the things you need to do in this game in order to play it and play it well, presumably. What kind of actions would you come up with? So I'm asking you to do the same thing that I asked you to do before where you said, well, go to the doorway and, you know, that kind of thing. So I'm asking you to do the same thing here, but in Pac-Man Land.
Sure, I could give that a try. I mean, I feel like in some ways this is harder than the other example because it was nice to be able to just navigate to that plus one and know that our task was complete. Here, there's a lot of things going on.
Yeah, but you're going to have to simplify it for me. And so abstract away, simplify it for me.